Hi everyone, welcome back to Aphrodite Menoneal Tarot. Thank you very much for joining our channel today. I'm going to be doing a general reading. I am going to go a little bit intuitively on this, okay? I have a song playing in the background called Till I Get Used to Losing You. I think it's called. Till I Can Make It on My Own. It's called Till I Can Make It on My Own. I'm not really sure who sings it. Could be Tammy Wynette. It's an old song. I feel like it's very, very related to the video I'm about to do. So you might want to gravitate and listen to the lyrics of that song. Okay. Alright, so please only take what resonates and leave the rest. Don't make the story fit if it's not your story. Hopefully that's not too loud, but I can't get to it right now. It's coming through a speaker. Alright. Alright, we have appreciation, we have the yin and yang, and we have the sun card. Alright. I have got notes, basically, because when I get a download, I can sometimes forget by the time I get to the actual video. Alright, I feel that you were in a very caring connection with somebody. I feel like there was a lot of love here in this connection. I feel like there was a lot of happiness according to the sun card. And I feel like that you and this person gave each other a lot. Until other energies came in the middle between you and this person. Okay? I'm going to tell you that someone is being very disrespectful towards you, okay? I feel like that you feel ignored or rejected by this person, and someone doesn't want you to question them about anything that they've done in the past, okay? I feel like that you were the yin to the yang of this person, so they were a twin flame or a soulmate to you. But I also feel that they were ill-advised, they, you know, connected to toxic people that made you and this person fall apart, okay? Now, I really feel that you felt that this person was lying to you, betrayed you, and, you know, they may have been trying to give you an excuse to keep you tied up for a little while, but their intention was to actually walk away, right? They wanted to experience other connections. They wanted to be with other people, whether it was sexual, whether it wasn't, that they were having their ego stroked and, you know, they went in that direction, okay? This person is a bit careless and doesn't want to admit the mistakes that they made, okay? They're kind of like keeping up a false facade towards you, that they're happy and everything is going well in their life and they've got so much work and they're busy, but deep down inside, they are so lost. They are so lost, not only just lost, but they feel empty because all these people that they're gravitating to, they mean nothing. They mean nothing. They're all ins and outs and they don't care about this person. You were the person that cared about this person. They may be connected to another person and even that person doesn't even care about them. They're more or less saying to them, go do whatever you want to do, okay? Just come home at the end of the day. There's no love there. There is no love there whatsoever, okay? There's no positive outcome with this false facade. There can't be any positive outcome. I feel that you helped this person. You, how do I explain this? That you may have made suggestions to this person You may have guided them in certain directions that paid off financially, and not only paid off financially, but gave them the name that they needed to make for themselves. And yet someone else got the accolades for that. You didn't. Okay? They didn't thank you or appreciate anything that you did for them. And this is going to bring in so much regret to this person. Okay? They are thinking about you as you are thinking about them. But because there's no communication, you're taking action to walk away from this. You don't want to be disrespected anymore. You loved this person even with the flaws that they had, even with knowing that they had, this toxic behavior. But you looked deeper into this person's heart. You looked deeper into this person's soul, and you saw a good person regardless of the flaws. And at the end, they didn't appreciate anything. You were very patient with this person. You ignored a lot of things, okay? They're miserable. They're miserable without you, and they have lots of regrets. And they regret their actions towards you. They know that they have a weakness and are easily enticed by others. You have discovered some truth, and they don't want to be questioned about that truth, okay? But they are watching you. They are watching you, okay? At the end of the day, I feel like they just failed to get it right with you. I'm sorry. They failed to get it right with you, okay? Making you wait is the biggest mistake that they could ever do, okay? They gravitated to other people. They had options. They had people that were may have been financially stable. They gravitated towards people that were financially stable, pretending that they love their life, pretending that everything is fine and that, you know, the doors have opened up to them. A lot of bullshit. They're actually very envious of you. Very envious of you, okay? You were the yin to the yang to this person, okay? So without you, they are lost. They are lost. Everything is all temporary, and they're going to have so much regret that they did not treat you better. They have created obstacles between you and them, okay? They've been giving their time and energy to toxic people. This person is going to go through some sort of divorce here. There's going to be legal documents that have to be signed, okay? Something is going to happen here. The false mask is going to drop. It's going to drop. They have no boundaries, no healing powers, no happiness, and no plans, okay? They actually have no plans. They're just going here, 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 wherever the day takes them, all right? I kind of feel like that you have a long time connection with this person. So I kind of feel like that they keep repeating a pattern with you, keep repeating mistakes of their past with you, okay? Too many times. Their biggest mistake is they walked away from you. Someone who truly, truly cared for them, okay? I actually feel that you loved this person very, very much, all right? So... sorry, I just need to look at my notes. I feel like this person does think about you a lot, okay? The things that you did to help them. Now they realize that no one cares about them as much as you did. Nobody cares about them as much as you did. You actually really, really care, okay? Not even their partner cares. People are talking about you. Why are they talking about you? There was a jealous woman who was very envious of you, and she wanted to dirty your name. She wanted to, but there are other people that are talking about you because of the good deeds that you've done, because of the people that you've helped, because the journey that you decided to take on your own, okay? And I kind of feel that, you know, the people that are talking about you are actually talking good things apart from this woman who is jealous of you. But they're also talking about this person. There's gossip going around about this person, and you may have heard it. You may have heard it through the grapevine, all right? Okay, so I kind of feel that you were a gift to this person to put them on a path of, you know, possible spirituality, helping them heal their issues from the past, teaching them things that possibly could open up their mind to the possibilities of what they can do, okay? This is not a controlling nature. This is you being gifted to this person, because the universe has been watching this person go round and round in circles, okay? But when you connected with this person, there was something about your energy and their energy when you united, that it was like two souls became one. You intertwined, okay? So whenever this person goes through anxiety, you feel it. Whenever you're happy, they feel it, okay? But what they're also feeling is you walking away. That's what they're feeling, that you will not tolerate any more of this, okay? You won't tolerate any more deceits. There you go. Even though I got it in my notes, you'll be walking away because you feel that this person is deceitful, okay? I think you're taking your spiritual path, and it's a good path that you're going to take because it's going to lead you to a lot of personal healing and happiness, and it's going to give you strength, all right? So they actually don't want you to know about their sneaky behavior, but you've got enough experience with this person to know, okay? But there is a lot of gossip going around, okay? Someone's feeling like they're having like a mental breakdown, but it's just actually a karma. Like they're starting to receive a karma for their past actions towards you or towards somebody else. I don't know. But you do play a part in this karma because of they may have repeated cycles with you, okay? You are feeling that this cycle has ended though, okay? You are walking away from the drama. You don't want the drama, all right? I feel like that you tried to communicate with this person, but they are totally ignoring you and making you feel rejected and making other people feel more important than you, okay? I do like your outcome though, but I don't like their outcome. Okay, so I kind of feel like there's no justice here. There's no balance, there's no justice, there's no truth, okay? They are reckless and they are drowning in their own emotions, even though they're putting on a false facade of being happy and content. But they regret ghosting you or avoiding you, okay? They're kind of used to playing this manipulating game, okay? To get their way. They always want their way. They're like a child, like it's got to happen their way. You know, it's my way or the highway. Okay. But it is actually coming where this person is broke and blocked and, you know, they're living a life that is full of illusions. Okay. And, they're always taking a wrong turn. They don't take the wrong turn. Even if they feel like they took the wrong turn, don't worry. It's going to be proven to them that they were wrong. All right. Anyway, they are being fake even to themselves. That's what I can tell you. All right. Someone needs to communicate, but you're already stepping into a new journey, new energy. You're going towards love, you're going towards happiness, you're going towards security. These are all the things that you planned. Now, you may have taken a time for you to get there, but you're on that journey and you are going to get there. You got the door to value, the door to healing, and you also got a man holding a heart for you. So there is a connection for you in the future, okay? You know, and this is because your energy is going to change. You're going to heal and you're going to value yourself a lot more. You know, no matter how much you loved and cared for this person, it is not being recognized. And even if it is, they feel ashamed to come back towards you. They feel that they have to explain themselves to you, and they don't want to explain themselves to you. They want to continue in this illusion that they live, and yet they can solve all this problem by actually communicating. All right? But there is going to be a time in this person's future where they are going to free themselves. They're going to free themselves from this woman who holds the financial connection. There is going to be a separation and a divorce and paperwork that is going to be signed. All right? Now, I get the feeling by the time this person makes this decision and wakes up that you will be well and truly, you know, healed, valuing yourself, and have this new person in there in your life, a man that is holding it up for you. And they're going to be very envious of you, and they're going to have a lot of regret to letting you go, okay? Because you were the one person that actually truly, truly cared. So as the story goes, I love you too much to ever start liking you, so don't expect me to be your friend. You feel that you cannot befriend this person again because they are just going to hurt you again, all right? They are angry with a group of people that they associate with, an environment of people, or a group of people that caused this person to turn against you. Maybe they got involved in drinking, toxic behavior, drugs, whatever they did. It caused this person to actually turn against you. You may have warned this person about these people, but they didn't listen. Okay, so someone let go of a dream, someone let go of a gift, which was you, and somebody headed towards people that have toxic behavior and don't have the good intention. They don't care about this person, okay? I feel like this person is doing something to honor you. They're doing something that they want to remember you by, and they're doing it as a form of forgiveness, okay? Whether they're lighting a candle for you, whether they have a tattoo of something, either your name or something that you two associate with together, okay? Or maybe they're creating an altar and lighting a candle and asking for your forgiveness, all right? But I'm guessing all you wanted was communication, but they tested you mentally, spiritually, and dealing with all this emotionally on your own, that they could not come in and just put their arms around you and apologize or ask you for forgiveness. They don't need to ask you for forgiveness, but they were ashamed to come towards you. They were. And because of all these actions that they are taking now in their life, you will be going in a different direction. And yet you held this person in high honor. But they mistreated you. They dragged your name through the mud, and they now have major regrets, okay? So I feel like you're tired of waiting. You're turning your back on this situation. Wherever they're doing, whatever they're doing, is making things worse, okay? They're trapped, and they're gonna be even more trapped, okay? You know, and pretending to be content, and they do want to free themselves. They do, okay? And they know that you're hurt. They know that you're hurt, and they were not grateful. They didn't appreciate you. I'm getting it very strong that they did not appreciate you, where they had you, they had the trust, they had the protection, they had the guidance, and they had the gift, and the gift was you. And they turned their back on all that for financial gain, for ego, for pride, for attention seeking, okay? For a toxic behavior that is just going to all end up, this person will end up, I don't want to say in the street. I don't want to say in the street, but they're going to end up gravitating towards wanting to make any connection so they can have a place to stay with somebody, and yet they know that they can just come towards you. They can come towards you and they can just ask for help, and you would help them. You know, it's not in your nature, but I don't see you going back into a connection with this person, but I can see you helping them. All right, they are trusting the wrong people right now. You know, things are going to be exposed. You know, I feel like that you're just now moving on, being carefree, and they're going to be cut out of your life. If they can't be bothered to communicate, making you feel rejected, you're not going to tolerate this disrespect towards you. As a matter of fact, I feel that they're just embarrassed and ashamed for not trusting you or understanding the connection. Okay, deep down, they are drowning and they are scared. They are. Okay. You protected this person, but I see you moving in a different direction and leaving the past in the past, okay? I don't feel you want to have anything more to do with any of this, okay? You may have a lot of your I've got here that you may have lost your ship towards this person. There you go, the hostility. Wow. I feel like you lost your shit towards this person, and you just said it how it was, and you were not going to put up with any more lies, because there is a realization that just came into play when this person was trying to play a game with you, okay? You woke up straight away and you said, fuck this shit, I am not going to go through a repeated pattern. You know, I am sick and tired of this fucking bullshit, and block. You blocked, all right? And at that point, they realized that you were not going to play any games with them, okay? You may not have had the evidence or felt or knew what was really going on, but your gut, your intuition and everything was enough for you to know to step back from this. You're not easily fooled, I can tell you now. You may have a sense of hope, but you're choosing to protect your peace, okay? You're going to choose to protect your peace of mind. You love them despite their flaws, but you learned the hard way, and that you were being loyal to somebody who will never be loyal to you, you know? But your future shows a lot of happiness, okay? I do feel you have the protection of your angels that might be connected to maybe Egypt or something. You are coming into happiness with your family. You're going to heal from this broken heart, because you have a very big heart to heal, okay? I feel like you had the protection of the spirits. You know, you were very well protected. And you may have waited for this person for a period of time. But now you have rested. You've gone through some change in your life. You've made some choices. You're waiting for that direction so you can just go, move forward, okay? Like, there's a plan in the making, but you need to wait for things to fall into place or paperwork to be done, and then you will make a decision, okay? I think this person doesn't even want to look at themselves in the mirror, because they know that they manipulated the whole situation. They were being promiscuous with people in the community, okay? And they let go of this love. You were heaven sent. Angel of love was heaven sent towards this person, okay? You're coming in as the goddess. And you see things very, very clearly. You do. And that's why you're moving on. Okay, you gave this person ample opportunity to come in and fix the situation, but they feel ashamed, they feel regret, they feel that, you know, you will never have them back. But I feel that your energy is shifting. You're no longer wanting to wait for this anymore. You waited long enough, okay? So I kind of feel that, you know, you got new beginnings that is coming in. You have a person that is holding a heart for you. I don't believe that this is a past energy. But this past person, they actually truly loved you, and yet they never told you, they never admitted it to you, okay? They created this storm warning. They created it, all right? And it brought in a lot of hostile energy between you and this person. But this person, you had a soul contract, I'm not going to lie to you, all right? But they gravitated towards other people. Okay, we have a saying in Australia, and I'm not saying it in a bad way, but they gravitated towards cashed up bogans. That's but for anybody that knows what that means, that's what they gravitated to. They gravitated towards cashed up bogans that were just false people, false toxic people that they drink a lot, they swear a lot. They're flirty, they're dirty, you know, and they want to get caught up with all these people. Well, at the end of the day, these people destroyed the connection between you and them because they should have trusted you when you said stay away from them. And they didn't. But you got the card of Cornucopia, and that is all the blessings in the world that is coming your way. You've been patient in this situation long enough, and now the gift will come towards you, the man holding the heart. You're going into a beautiful connection. Be patient, okay? It's been hard. It's been a struggle. You've had your ups and downs. Your mind sometimes gravitates back to this person. Sometimes you feel like you just want to hear their voice. You want to communicate with them. But they're rejecting. They're making you feel rejected. You know, they're gravitating towards other people. They're lying about their life. They're lying to themselves. Okay. I do feel if I had to do another read that this person will be knocking on your door. Because I feel in the future they come towards you because they need help. It is said, it is written, the prophecy will happen. And with that, I shall bid you good night and take care. And thank you for watching. Please press the like button if you like the video. Thank you. Bye.